these guys were here earlier last year. Hell of a matchup they had. See, look at the audience clapping.
Introducing first, the team C, Chris Castro, Matt Nix, and Kenny Sutra from Chicago, Illinois. They are the four-star heroes.
We've seen before what Matt Nix and Kenny Sutra can do, and Chris Castro adding a different dynamic to the fight.
Last time watching Kenny Sutra and Matt Nix take on Guns and Beer, they were flying off everything. They were jumping all over the place. Those two are quick little bastards.
Their opponents.
It's Piranha. We haven't seen him in ages.
Oh, no.
Hailing from the Amazon. Piranha!
Chop, chop, Bruce, chop, chop!
Who let that animal out of his cage?
Tank!
Tank!
But who cares? He's here!
He's a wild animal, he needs to be restrained. Do we have a veterinarian on site?
Everyone loves Piranha!
Has he had his shots, Tony?
He's a fish!
He's gonna bite that audience member right there.
Chop, chop!
Hey, stay away from him! He's got sharp teeth! He's bloodthirsty! He's a psycho! Fans in Minot are heavily behind this man pretending to be a fish, which says a lot about the people here in Minot. Oh no. You know, the sounds of the gunshots and the country music playing, it can only mean one thing.
Man, look who's
introducing
back!
Introducing his partner from Kill Devil Hills, North Carolina, Joey Joe Dozer Anderson and Duke Cornell. They are the FLWK team champions, Guns and Beer!
Joey filling in for his good buddy Bogot tonight. Bogot unfortunately injured a few weeks back in a different setting. But Duke's back. He's one eye short,
Duke's
but he's back.
He's a Cyclops now. This could be an interesting dynamic. Bogot and Duke Cornell are always good together. But I haven't seen much of Joey Anderson and Duke Cornell together.
Worked together in this capacity, but not at this level, not in a championship stakes match. This isn't for the belts, but it has implications for those belts later on.
I tell you, they have their belts. They need to provide a championship quality match to show that they've earned that right.
And they will, I'm sure. But we've seen what Joe Dover can do by himself. We know what Duke's capable of.
After all, Sean did win it for them.
This is going to be fantastic.
Sean Nautilus, I mean.
Shooting some clay pigeons, it looks like.
So we got 3 men in gym shorts versus 2 rednecks and a fish.
Interesting, isn't it? Only at FLW.
Only at FLW, Tony.
It looks like not to state the obvious, but I'm going to. Duke's at a bit of a disadvantage here. He's only got one eye.
Oh, I thought you were going to say he's inebriated.
Well, maybe that too. If you only have one eye and you get double vision for drinking, is that just single vision then or normal vision?
Monocular vision, yes.
If you only have one eye, though, and it becomes double vision, is that stereo again?
I'm not quite sure. Perhaps we should ask him.
I think I will later. I'm curious now.
Yeah, no, I'm curious. Both teams strategize as he's going to start off the match. Matt Nix, Kenny Sutra, and Chris Castro, the four-star heroes. Without Chris Castro, it's just a Dojo of Electric Muscle. Those two were here in this very hotel.
One year ago.
Fantastic match.
They were here at the beginning. They're here a year later.
Tell you, I saw it from ringside. Watching them fly through the air was a thing of beauty, Tony.
First night ever for an FLW event. The little man there, Kenny Sutra, jumped off the second balcony here at the Vegas, wowing everybody.
He was like a
setting
dove.
The stage for what to expect.
It was like a dove in flight, Tony.
It was beautiful.
Yes, graceful.
And a few months later, jumping off the office roof over there, who knows what's going to happen this weekend? We just don't know.
Like a swan landing in a lake. Just graceful.
Big splash, a little bit wet?
Yeah.
I see.
Looks like Joey Anderson's going to start off against Kenny Sutra.
Ring the bell. Fucking bell.
So we got this match starting off here. Kenny Sutra and Joey Anderson. So we're going to have a wooing contest. They're pacing, trying to size each other up. Kenny Sutra getting the audience clapping, getting them fired up. This is going to be a hell of a match.
Yes, it is, Bruce.
Kenny Sutra going behind, but Joey Anderson countering too. He ain't going to have any of that. Joey Anderson bringing up the size difference. A little cocky.
That's well deserved. The man can he can hold on in a fight. We've seen that. Kenny Sutra going low.
Oh, but right away, Joey Anderson with that headlock. Taking Kenny Sutra down.
That's going to be part of the game plan. Joe and Duke and Piranha have to keep in mind here is keeping Matt Nix and Kenny Sutra on the ground.
Right. These guys are high flyers. You get them moving. You end up losing track of them. Next thing you know, they're coming from the sky. They're coming from the rafters. They're coming from every which way. You got to make sure they're grounded, keep them down, keep them planted, and that's how you win this match.
100% correct, Bruce. Cover. 1-2.
It's not enough, though.
You got to keep in mind as well, though, Matt Nix, Kenny Sutra, and Chris Castro are not only. Wow. They're not only known for the high flying, they've also possessed great wrestling skills.
Oh yeah.
Which looks like we're about to see here.
These guys are phenomenal. Like in the ring, outside the ring, anywhere. If they're wrestling, they're top quality.
Going for the drop kick.
But you can't sell Joey Anderson or Guns and Beer short.
Oh, absolutely not. What was that? Tagging in Duke
Cornell. I haven't seen him since he got his eye injury. We'll see how he can fare. He could have some ring rust coming in the ring.
Well, he said he was training as much as he could, so it's probably not that bad, but he's definitely at a disadvantage here with only one eye. Matt Nix tagged in, legal man now on the four-star hero side.
I'm surprised Matt Nix looks in pretty good shape after he got murdered by Hammerstone last month.
He's a tough guy.
Surprisingly. Hides a lot of toughness under that outside at appearance. Duke Cornell with a size advantage and the power advantage over Matt Nix.
Definitely winning this test of strength here.
But he's not winning the test of sight.
No. Matt Nix holding his own, though.
Oh, monkey flip!
Beautiful. Holding him down with that pin, keeping the shoulders up, though, Duke is.
Both men bridging.
Very impressive bridge from Duke.
They don't seem to want to give up. They're not letting go. Duke Cornell's losing the test of strength. He's got him down on his head. Matt Nix mounting Duke Cornell.
Put the shoulders down.
Oh.
Man, great strength from Duke, though. Very impressive. Duke getting himself out of it. Now he's in control.
Duke's getting ahead of steam. What was that? Sportsmanship. Hey, wrestling.
Showing great respect for each other, but there's still a wrestling match on.
All of lost. Respect can only last so long. You got to get back to the match. Look at that. Quicker than a hiccup, Matt Nix right up on his feet.
Big arm drag. Duke with one of his own.
Oh, ducked out of it.
Stopping the kick short.
Matt Nix got Duke Cornell's arm. He ain't giving it back.
Definitely keeping Duke on his toes here. Ducking the big boot.
No one home.
Ducking the punch. Both men reading each other like books, just not quick enough to get each other one over the other.
These men both. Duke Cornell did face these guys. He knows what to expect. They know what to expect.
Matt Nix saying, hell yeah, I'll take on the fish.
He's got, five wrestlers in the ring, and then he got a fish.
Fan favorite here, Piranha. Been around Minot Wrestling for a long time. Biting
hey,
the fingers.
That is unsanitary. Where has he been? Oh, hey.
It's a clean tank. I've seen it.
Hey.
Chris Castro getting a bit of it himself.
Like, what even is Piranha? Look at that. Hey.
He's a fish, you moron.
Biting is unsanitary. That is not, wrestling is not biting. He isn't trained. He needs to be trained.
Chris Castro using that superior size, taking him down with the shoulder block. Showing great athleticism and quickness.
That is a quickness you would not expect from a man of that frame.
Reminds me a bit of Samoa Joe in that respect. Big man, great quickness, great agility.
He's got
an awesome strength.
And once again, he's biting him.
Well, he is a piranha, that's what he does.
It's not feeding time, it's wrestling time.
If you're a piranha, it's always feeding time,
Uh-oh.
Bruce.
Oh! See, if I were fighting a fish, I'd knock out his teeth. That wouldn't work on his hand. Oh.
Oh, honestly.
He's got him by the fin.
He does. I was just about to say, Chris Castro is lucky that this fish has hands to work on.
It's a weird fish, more like a fish man.
Well, he had some time at...
Oh, look at this head of steam. Oh!
Rumor has it he spent some time in a pond but near Chernobyl.
Near Chernobyl.
Chris Castro covered. One, two. Piranha gets the shoulder up.
So Piranha, there's a lot of piranhas over in Chernobyl?
No, just the one. He's here now.
Oh, just the one.
Yeah. And that's just rumor. I'm not sure if it's true or not. It might have been a 3 Mile Island. I'm not sure. Or for all I know, I'll be lied to.
Oh! Chris Castro, my God. Attacking the fish's legs. This must be like the Darwin theory of evolution at work
here.
Of
the things that you never thought you'd say, Bruce.
I know. FLW is great. It's making me say things I never thought I'd say in my entire life.
Right, and they're not all horrible.
I know.
One,
oh,
two.
Thanks. Is that a compliment, Tony?
No. Tagging in Kenny Sutra.
Kenny Sutra, lightning quick, lightning light. Oh!
Chris Castro, one, two. Chris Castro using that light frame of Kenny's as a weapon.
Four-star heroes showing that in this matchup, the four-star heroes have the experience and the chemistry.
Big elbow drop.
They even went so far as to wear matching attire.
Big leg drop. Somehow missing.
He got a little too full of himself. Fish can be slippery, Tony.
Oh, fisherman suplex. Oh. Imagine that.
Is that ironic, a fish using a fisherman suplex?
It works. Tagging in Joe Dozer.
Joey Anderson right to the back of Kenny Sutra.
And again and again and again. One, two, only two again.
Kenny Sutra staying in this.
He's tougher than that, Bruce.
Oh, I've seen him in the ring. This man is...
big, bear hug, vicious.
Throwing him around like he was a one-year-old infant.
I don't know what you do at home, Bruce, but I'm tired of hearing about it, honestly. It scares me.
I don't have any children.
Joey and that, clearly. I hope not. Duke taking the kicks to Kenny.
Duke Cornell capitalizing on his down opponent.
Set up for a gut wrench suplex, possibly. Yep, there it is.
It's like throwing around a watermelon. Like, wait, you know, just little.
Castro there to save the day.
Hey, keep him out of the ring, ref. Kenny Sutra fighting back.
Clubbing blow to the back. Kenny Sutra, he's in trouble here. Oh!
Duke Cornell using his size and strength to his advantage.
Giving it back to Joe Dozer.
Joey going up top.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Good double team maneuver from these two.
Oh, a double stomp to the lower back.
That'll put blood in your stool.
You can see the agony in Kenny Sutra's face. Hook the leg, one, two. That next saves the day. Notice everyone's trying to keep it civil here. This isn't about who the bigger man is. It's about competition.
Looks like it's about to get heated here. I don't know.
Ooh, taking it to the turnbuckle.
It's wise of Joey Anderson keeping his partner away from his side.
Pressure on that abdomen. If you can weaken the core of a man like Kenny Sutra, that eliminates a lot of the maneuvering. All those high aerial maneuvers take a lot of core strength, Bruce.
Oh, yeah. I knew that, actually.
I'm glad.
Yeah. I actually knew that. Look at that. I'm not completely ignorant.
Well, I'm surprised being from Minnesota, you damn Swede.
Yeah, hey. At least we have trees and lakes.
We have tree here.
We have tree.
And we had at one point the third largest man-made lake.
Man-made?
Yes, Lake Sakakawea. Third largest man-made lake for a long, long time. From 1954 until China did something.
Oh.
Duke with that bear hug of his own.
Violently. Smart, though, keeping him away from his partners.
Also, for those at home, Lake Sakakawea is a world-renowned walleye fishery.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, look at that. Learn something new every day.
Ooh.
Oh, my God.
Big clothesline.
I think running into a
cover.
Tree branch.
One, two. Kenny kicks out on his own. Matt Nix trying to get to his friend to help him out, though. Joe Dozer tagged in, legal man.
Talk about chemistry with tag teams here, and it seems that Joey Anderson and Duke Cornell, they're haven't lost a beat. Read
Absolutely
each other well,
not.
Keeping each other fresh.
And so they have worked together as a tag team before.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm just complimenting Duke Cornell on, you know, eye injury and all. He's still in the ring, and he's...
he is doing a great job with only one eye.
Haven't lost a beat at all.
Kenny Sutra fighting back. Big backbreaker.
Stop, my God.
One, two.
He's paralyzed. Someone call the medic. Is Mason still around? Have him turn that ambulance around.
Well, he's gone. Griffin to the hospital now.
We should come back. We might need that for this match.
Torquing that lower back. Also, most certainly going to limit his maneuvering on the top rope.
Oh, yeah. If you have a damaged... oh, he picked him up like he was a baby.
Powering him up. Nearly deadlifting him. And I know he doesn't weigh that much, but my God.
It's always a spectacle watching a grown man pick another grown man up.
Kenny Sutra fighting back with headbutts. Injuring yourself to injure your opponent.
Backbreaker. Kenny Sutra needs to capitalize. Matt Nix and Chris Castro are going nuts on their side of the ring. Duke Cornell and Piranha want a tag. Who's going to get the tag first? Duke Cornell, Chris Castro in the ring.
Castro in firm control. Oh, big uppercut.
Oh! Spinning back kick. How does he move that fast? Oh, vicious spine buster.
And then this side moving that quickly is even more dangerous because he's got momentum behind him.
That is absolutely Joe terrifying. Dozer.
Massive uppercut.
Wild uppercut from this man. Another, oh, super kick out of nowhere. Duke Cornell.
Oh!
Clothesline rush and leg sweep combo. Look at that double team maneuver.
One, two. Kenny Sutra that'll break things up. Clubbing blow to the back, Joe Dozer. Joey looking like he was expecting to go for a backdrop, and Sutra saw it. And now
he's able to counter.
You
now
see
he's
the result now.
Oh, no! This is absolute pandemonium.
That was beautiful.
Now Duke Cornell, oh! His right hand's going down low with those kicks. And again, off the turnbuckle! Wait, Duke Cornell countering. See that lower back?
That could have been ugly for Kenny.
Wait a minute.
Oh, dang it! Wow, huge pile driver.
His spine could be broken in half. That kick to the back of the head there. And now Piranha's in the ring. Matt Nix and Piranha, the only two standing.
Thumb spike to the clavicle there. Nerve cluster, very painful.
Hurts like a fish, Tony.
Hurts like a fish. I like it.
See, the bitch is like a dog thing. Oh! Hey! That can't be legal.
He's been warned.
Oh! What'd he do? What happened?
I'm not sure.
You don't smell your fingers after
he's
that.
He's been out of water too long.
Oh, he's
diving to the outside.
Piranha's dried up. Piranha's dried up. Where's Castro? Oh! Bending him in half.
Deep in a clover leaf. Piranha tap!
Your winners of this match, the team of Matt Nix, Kenny Sutra, and Big C Chris Castro, the 4-Star Heroes!
What a showing tonight by the 4-Star Heroes. Last time they heard, Dojo of Electric Muscle lost to Guns and Beer. But even if Piranha was still pinned, this is still a loss and a win in their favor. Four-Star Heroes looking to celebrate for a little bit here. And they got reason to celebrate. What a phenomenal matchup.
The next match is a semifinal match in the No Limit Tournament. Once again, we are going to crown our No Limit champion tomorrow night, right here at the Vegas Motel. The winner will face Suede Thompson for the No Limit title.
I'm over here!
Suede Thompson taking over commentary right now.
I love you guys. My shirts are over there still.
All right. Here we go.
Semi-final action for the No Limits Tournament. Scott Story makes his way to the ring.
Scott Story, all right. This is my first time actually seeing him in person.
Introducing our first competitor in this match. From Fargo, North Dakota, Scott Story!
Oh, thought he just punched that little girl in the front.
Oh, he wouldn't do that. He's a nice guy.
He is a nice guy. I think it was just a high five. So, Scott Story or Matt Cage will go ahead and face myself tomorrow.
Do you have a preference?
I actually do not have a preference. I am very confident in my abilities, and I think that tomorrow I will be victorious. Matt Cage is one hell of an opponent. I've known him for many years, This will be my first time seeing Scott Story in action, so I'll have a better answer for you probably halfway through the match.
Well, I promise you, Scott Story is no slouch. He'll hold his own. He obviously got the semifinals.
Yes, exactly. I have seen some video on him. He's very impressive. And I am very much looking forward to this match, as I think it'll be a very high-paced back-and-forth bout. So we'll see semifinals right here at FLW, Fully Loaded Wrestling, for the No Limits, first ever No Limits champion. Crowd's into it.
Absolutely. We've got some of the best fans I've ever seen here.
Oh, man. Tonight has just been amazing.
Electric atmosphere.
Amazing. From beginning to right now, we're about, semi-main, and we have one after this. So
yep.
They have been with us the entire show, just nonstop action. Great energy from the crowd. Is Matt Cage ever going to come out?
He likes to build suspense.
He does? Is he coming out from there? Is he going to
come
down from the roof? Oh, there he is.
High energy as always, always ready for a fight.
His opponent for this match, coming to you from Las Vegas, Nevada, Money Matt Cage!
Throwing up the Nixon sign.
Asking for more from the fans.
Yes, and he's receiving it. Matt Cage's pecker puts asses in. Can I say that? Puts asses
well,
in
you
chairs?
Just did. Well,
I did. We might have to bleep that out, but
what
that's
am I
a sign.
Do, fire you?
No. Well, I don't know that you can. This is my first and only kick, I believe.
I don't have that kind of power.
Okay, well then, yes. Look at that sign. Cage just grabbed the sign. The fans here will be able to see the sign, hopefully. There you go. Take a look at it.
Oh, my.
That is absolutely amazing.
Wow.
Eric Cannon came over to take a picture. That's how amazing this is.
That's something.
That's good. And Matt Cage is putting Matt's cage on display. I will note that they forgot the apostrophe S. So
that's
maybe,
fine. It gets the job done.
It's okay. It works. That sign is also true. Oh yeah, this is gonna be a good one here. This is gonna be a
absolutely.
Really good one.
Absolutely. In the spirit of the No Limits.
Yes, exactly.
Championship belt is gonna be high flying, high octane.
That's exactly the best thing about it is the description is in the title itself, No Limits. I mean, the people that have been in this tournament, the people that, you know, compete for this type of spot are no holds. No punches held back, no moves held back, just straight to the wall.
Right,
non-stop action. This is exactly what this match is going to be.
Everyone in this tournament vying for a piece of FLW history, a first ever No Limits champion. A brave new direction for Fully Loaded Wrestling. I can't wait to see what the future holds for this division.
Yes, it's going to be amazing to add to the already existing amazing divisions that FLW already has. Can I drop down there? Oh, and a beautiful arm drag. Oh, into the key lock. There we go. Nice reaction from the crowd. The crowd can appreciate some good old-fashioned wrestling.
This crowd saw one hell of a fight between Matt Cage and Darren Colvin back in December.
Yes, I was actually here for that. That was
you were. Right.
I watched that match from beginning to end. I had goosebumps the entire time. That was an absolute amazing match.
Showing mine out what wrestling really can be. Showing the world what wrestling can be.
And exactly. Going back to the No Limits thing, just because No Limits, don't expect these guys to go in here and just throw a whole bunch of moves. These guys know how to wrestle. These guys know how to work. So it's going to be really good to see the mixture of both technical wrestling, that high-flying action, and just strong, stiff punches.
Right. And this division is a stepping stone to bigger, better things for anyone that's involved in it.
Agreed.
Matt Cage fighting his way to the ropes.
Shoots him off. Big shoulder tackle from Scott Story. Big shoulder tackle. It's a big boy right there.
He is, and he's quick.
Another drop down. Oh! Oh! Big calf kick there.
One.
About a one and a half, two. Okay.
Scott Storr is still in the fight. He's not going to give up that easy.
Not at all. No, we got another. Oh, headlock takeover. There we go. Matt Cage is going to try to take him down here, wear him out. Matt Cage using the mat to his advantage.
Close cousins? Matt Cage and the mat?
They are cousins. They are second cousin removed.
Oh, good.
I think the mat's name is also Cage.
That is actually interesting.
That's also a terrible joke.
Hey, that's what we do here.
That is what we do. So here we go. They're fighting back and forth. We're at a little bit of a stalemate here. Oh, big shoulder tackle.
Right, but like you're saying, still no clear advantage in this match.
Not at all. Oh, and a drop kick right there.
Big height from Scott Storr. One.
One right there. So it's pretty evenly matched here between Storr and Cage, exchanging with the calf kick and the drop kick. Equal. Now we have Storr on top here. He's going to go ahead and wear him down a little bit.
Matt Cage back to his feet. Trying to get himself out of this.
Oh, there we go. Ref's got to get out of the way. Come on, ref. Count him out. Get him out of the corner. I did notice that I wore purple, white, and pink, and Matt Cage is also wearing purple, white, and pink.
Huh. How about that?
Yeah. We have great taste in colors.
Apparently.
Yes.
I'm sorry. I didn't congratulate you for your win order today.
Oh, thank you very much, sir. I appreciate that. It was a hard-fought victory against Eric Walker, who's a great opponent. I believe he was the first ever Outlaw champion, right?
Yep.
I was happened to be victorious, so I'm very thankful for that. And, again, it was a very hard-fought bout, and I'm now waiting to see who I take on. The winner of this, Matt Cage or Scott Storr. Oh, my goodness.
Wow. Big swinging right.
Oh, big forearm.
Storr.
Answer that.
Fighting back.
That was a monstrous right hand by Matt Cage. I don't know how Storr's standing. Oh, kick. Oh!
Right. Oh! My God.
Oh, my goodness. That should be it. Pin him.
Got to get that cover. Got to capitalize. One, two.
Close. Two. Crowd's right with it with that two count. Oh, here we go. Cage is getting that energy. Feeling it.
Scott fighting back with those punches of the midsection.
Big snapmare. Oh, big drop kick to the mouth there. That should be it.
One, two.
Oh, kick there.
Not enough to keep Matt Cage down.
Yeah, but he's very hurt. Look at that. The agony and pain on his face. Oh, Scott Storr with a big elbow.
Matt Cage seems to be taking offense
to
that.
No. Matt Cage is not going down easily here. Oh, my goodness. Gigantic chop.
Felt that back here.
Yeah, you'd think he's half luchador. Uh-oh. Oh. Oof, that one hurt. That one hurt me. Oh, snap there by Cage. Big clothesline. Big lariat there.
One, two.
This is a seriously very evenly matched.
Right, hotly contested, both
just
men.
Back and forth here, they're exchanging almost not identical moves, but pretty similar here.
They seem to be reading each other very well.
Yes, it's very good here. Back and forth, I love it. And actually, to answer your question, I don't mind who is in the match with me, because these guys are great competitors. So no matter who's going to be in that match tomorrow with myself, Matt Cage or Scott Storr, I think the crowd and the No Limits title will get exactly what it deserves. One hell of a match.
Well, I'm certain of that.
Yes.
I am very excited for no matter who you end up facing. Big chop from Scott Storr.
Oh, Cage missed, and Storr is going to capitalize with a big chop of his own. Oh, he's just chopping him down like a... Oh, here we go. Cage has got him in. Oh, man, these guys' chests. I'm not looking forward to this.
Scott Storr ducking, countering with his own. And another. Got it on repeat.
Oh. If it's not broke, don't fix it.
Oh my goodness. Big swinging neck breaker there.
Big swinging neck breaker, but the thing is Cage is not capitalizing on these moves.
Right, and that could be his downfall.
That could be one, two. That might have been three if he had gotten on him right away or held the pin when he hit him with that move.
Exactly.
You know, these type of mistakes cannot be made tomorrow when that title is on the line.
I think maybe he's getting a little cocky in his...
I think he's very comfortable in there, and whether that's cockiness or just confidence, I'm not sure.
Storr with one of his
goodness
own.
On his head. That could
one,
be it.
Two, three.
Oh.
Oh, man.
Wow, and see how Story, you know, capitalized on that move and got right on him, but it just was not enough for Matt Cage. Wow, these guys are hitting each other with a lot here.
Not sure what he just said there, but
I don't know.
Serious.
What did he say? I don't know what he said. Something about the CFL?
Canadian Football League?
Yeah.
Huh.
Missed clothesline.
Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Double cross body.
Their solar plexus has to be killing them right now.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I hope they hit the ab machine for a couple hours this week.
Wow.
That was insane.
So what happens
if they both lose? Do I win by default or triple threat?
I don't mean to be presumptuous, but it might turn into a triple threat that
way. That's what I was going to think. Okay, well, let's hope that's not the case.
Right. But it's no limits.
It is no limits.
Oh!
Big enziguri. Matt Cage has stumbled.
Educated feet, as a wise man once said.
Oh.
Cross body of Matt Cage.
Oh, nipped up on his head.
Well, that's a good way to keep someone down.
Matt Cage is a turner. He just took four moves in a row and is just there.
Adrenaline flowing.
Yes, adrenaline is. Oh, big slap to the face. I thought he was going for a move there.
That was the move.
Oh, that was the move. Okay.
That was the move.
Okay. Oh!
Corkscrew uppercut from the metal rope.
That was impressive. Oh, he's dishing the money out.
He's making it rain. The kind of athleticism that this No Limits title has inspired has been amazing.
Oh, it's just, it's uncanny, man.
Wow.
Front face, DDT.
Big impact on that. One, two.
Oh, no. Two. I thought that was it.
That very well could have been it.
It could have been.
Cage somehow still in it.
These guys giving it their all. Probably absolutely beat to hell by now.
There's championship gold on the line. You don't just give up, right?
Not at all. No, if someone slaps on a submission in this type of match, you don't tap.
Right.
It breaks or you go to sleep. That's my mindset
for
this.
Do not give up.
Exactly. There's too much on the line for this. Oh, reversible of Matt Cage. Oh. Oh.
Lining up those shots nice and clean.
Oh. Oh, he's just punching the hell out of him at this point. Oh, no. Oh, no! What was that?
Was that a ball sweat?
Oh!
Are you sure you don't have a preference now?
Oh!
Shades of Kenta here from Scott Story.
Oh!
Huge impact.
That was awesome. They're both down. I would prefer there to be zero ball sweat in my match.
Well, one, two, three.
Oh, my God.
So
I thought that was it. I thought that was it.
I was about to say there, if you prefer no ball sweat, you want Scott Story.
I do want Scott Story. If there's no ball sweat.
Decreases the odds of the ball sweat.
The ball sweat is really leaning my choice now.
I don't blame you, really.
My goodness. Oh, hits him with the Negro. Oh. Uh-oh. What are we doing here? What we got? Scorpion Deathlock?
Can he get it in?
Does he have it? He's got to turn him over. Oh, he turns him over. There it is. He's got him. That should be it. I can't tell from this angle if he's close enough to the ropes.
He might be. I can't tell.
Is he under the ropes too? Oh, no. He's turning it over. Okay. There he goes. Breaks free.
Throwing him off the ropes.
Oh, sky high.
One, two, three. Oh my God. Scott Story barely hanging in there.
This is awesome.
Fans showing their appreciation for this No Limits bout.
This is awesome.
Okay.
Matt Cage feeding up the energy of the crowd.
Oh,
big
high
knee in the corner.
Oh, misses the knee.
For another.
Stinger splash.
That Got Story wildly on his feet.
Oh, Insiguri. Insiguri. Let's see what Story has here. Springboard forearm.
Beautiful.
He's waiting for him. Oh, sit out rock bottom? That was awesome.
One, two, three.
Oh, my goodness.
How is he staying
are
in this?
Are you serious?
Way?
These guys are going bananas in there, bro.
How do you stay in this through all this fight, all this damage?
I'm definitely going to have to dig down deep. Tomorrow I'm going to have to dig down deep regardless of who I face, whether it's Scott Story or Matt Cage. These guys are impressing the hell out of me right now.
Remember how Scott Story got here was through a three-way bout in that first round.
Oh, wow. That's right.
It was a hell of a fight.
Oh! Codebreaker. Is he under the ropes?
He might be.
His foot. He got his foot on the ropes. Oh, my God. The ring awareness that these two have is insane.
Matt Cage obviously showing frustration. Maybe a moment of haste there, not pulling him away from the ropes.
He's got to stay focused, though. He can't get frustrated with this.
Oh, he's got to keep a cool head. We know he can.
Oh.
Scott Story fighting back.
My goodness.
Taking a lot off himself with that maneuver, though.
Downward spiral, baby. Let's see. That should be it.
One, two.
Now Matt has his foot. Are you? Wow. Wow. Let me just.
Very impressive.
This is my applause. These guys are killing it right now. This is amazing.
Scott Story going up top. Matt Cage not having that.
He may have lost a tooth on that one.
Matt Cage said, not today.
What do we have here?
Interesting statement from Matt Cage.
That was very interesting dialogue there. Oh.
He's trying to set up for a big superplex, it looks like.
He can't get it. Story is, he's got himself, see how he's positioned himself behind the turnbuckle there for more leverage.
Matt Cage can't get the
leverage. Oh, big block by Story. Big, big forearm. Oh, he's down. What do we have here? Uh-oh, he's going up top. What do we have? This is what the No Limits brings right here.
Oh, no!
He got the knees up!
Oh, he got the knees up!
Oh, my God.
My goodness!
Oh! Scott Story's hurting after that.
Oh! Oh, that's it. That's it.
One, two, three. Wow. Uh-oh. What do you do to stop him?
Money clip. Money clip. That has to be it.
One, two, three.
That's it.
That's all. Matt Cage moves down to face
the
opponent.
That was amazing.
Of this match, in advancing to the finals of the No Limits Championship Tournament, Money Matt Cage!
Hell of a fight from both men.
That was absolutely grade A wrestling right there. That was intense.
You've got your work cut out for you, Todd Suede.
Yes, I do. I very much so do. Matt Cage, Suede Thompson, that has a very nice ring to it.
I can't wait.